right, guys, it's spring. It's finally spring. The grass is growing. It's green. And we got to get out there and start mowing some lawns. We have a bunch of accounts we got to start working on. And we're going to be building our landscaping and lawn care business. We're going to be doing not just mowing lawns. We're going to be doing a lot of other stuff like retaining walls, like concrete maybe, stuff like that. We're going to do it all. I think I got a mini excavator on order in a few months as well. So we are going to get busy. If you guys enjoy landscaping series, lawn mowing, any of that stuff, make sure to subscribe. I'm going to have a lot more videos coming out, a lot of cool mods that we're going to bring into the series. But right now, we got to get her set up. I want to show you the shop, show you all the equipment we got, my house. That's pretty much where we're going to run the business out of. So starting off, I got a plain Jane 4. These trucks are nice. Don't get me wrong, but it's about as plain as you can get. It's an F-250 Super Duty, and then it's the XL trim line. And the only few things I opted in to make it better than just the base model is I got the 6.7 liter Power Stroke just because we're going to be towing a lot. Like I said, we're going to have skid loaders. We're going to have mini excavators. So we're going to need the diesel. Got the plow prep package for when winter rolls around. And then I think that's it for add-on. So obviously adding a diesel engine is like $10,000 more. But this is about as plain Jane as I could get of a truck. Of course, got the crew cab because we're going to have the crew back there. I got a toolbox. I wanted to get a fuel tank and a toolbox, but they're just too expensive. So then running, I want to mainly run all gooseneck trailers. I got two PJs. I got two PJs. One's a bumper pull, one's a gooseneck. This is a 40 foot. This is our beast. This is our big Bertha. And she can hold a lot. Tandem axles with the 8 big old tires back there. Commercial rated, heavy duty ply tires. And then we got our dump trailer. This is actually 16 footer dump trailer. So typically they're 14, but they're 16. I'm going to probably get more trucks on the fleet. Probably get a dually here soon. First things first, let's start loading up. I can go over our mowers. They're pretty simple mowers. This is the 648R. It's a stand-on. I love stand-ons. It's just about perfect. It's the 48-inch deck, I believe. It might be a 52. I'll have to look again. All right, what's nice about these trailers is, one, we have plenty of deck space, and then, two, we can store all of our weed eaters. We've got weed eater racks, extension cords, blowers, shovels, everything, ear protection, all that stuff. So it's perfect. The one, my favorite mower that we got is the Skag Cheetah. It's got a diesel 30 horsepower engine. So my plan is with that, just the diesel engine, one, it's going to last a really long time, just reliability. And then it'll be my mower if we ever get into thick stuff. If we ever get into any thick grass, overgrown, just county issued accounts where they find a resident or find a property and tell them that they have to get it cleared. Typically, this is what we're going to use to get called on those big jobs. But everything else is gas. The 2-0 turns are 22 or 24 horsepower, so they don't have a crazy amount of horsepower, but they're fine. And then also the Skag, I'm going to put a bagger on it in the fall. So that's why the extra horsepower is nice when we are mulching up the leaves. But if you guys want to play with these mowers, they are public thanks to Buck and Austin Farmer. And I think a few others that did edits to it, or not edits, put in work on them. It's the Massive Mower Pack. Just search it up on Google. It's only for PC, but it is public. All right, we got everything loaded up. It looks good. The Power Stroke she pulls nice, and I got the gooseneck on there, so we can haul a lot, and it's a lot more comfortable when most of the weight is on the truck bed instead of the hitch. What's nice is my place is right next to a Casey's, so in the morning we can always go there for gas, and then we can go there for donuts. We can breakfast pizza, the whole nine yards. But my place is right up here. You can actually see our shop. So I wanted to do a barn durindium. Where you have your house and the shed connected. I can't pronounce how that is. Or I haven't heard it. I've only seen it. But the wife said no, and we had to make it separate. So it's a 75 by 100. So it's pretty wide as it is long. Just 25 feet longer. Then this is my house. So I can do a house tour some other time, but sure, what you guys are most curious on is the shop. So let's get all the doors opened up here. Here she is. So here is the main shop. This is the 100 feet by 75. And then we have office space added on the side. So that's where we can do all the office work and stuff, kind of get out of the noisy compressors and the impact guns and all the tools running. So that's my favorite part. I'll actually show you guys the office real quick. Here's some workbench. I got to get all my tools organized. But here's the office space. It actually has some living quarters as well. So I could put like a bed in here. Or I think this couch actually pulls out. So if my workers, if we have a late night and then an early morning the next night, I guess they could always stay here. And then this is my desk area. Super nice. Got a gun safe, of course. And then washer dryer so the workers can come bring in their dirty clothes if something happens. And then they can shower off, use the restroom, sink, all that stuff. So it's perfect. Got some loft space up there for when No, we can store seed up there. It's pretty strong, so we'll store quite a bit up there. So here's the mowers. I'm going to get them going in here. I'll probably park them in the back. Like I said, we're just starting this out, getting everything organized. I actually might mow some lawns here today, so stay tuned. For those who are wondering what map this is, it's County Line. The home base, or the main shop is going to be on County Line, and then we have neighboring cities, and we're going to be on Nebraska lands, and then I want to try a few other maps out as well, so that we aren't always mowing the same place, and it's going to be a lot of fun. We can do construction spots or some construction maps, so I'm very excited for this series. But like I said, the main shop will be on here, and then we can always transition to different maps. I know you guys like that a lot. And for those watching who are on PC, maybe in my Discord, I am going to have it hopefully public here in a few episodes from now. So I want workers on here. It would be a lot of fun. Fans who like to watch and maybe play with, you guys can. So I'm going to try and get the mods scheduled or get them posted so that you guys can download most of these mods. Some, hopefully, I can get things set up where it's easy to download and they're all public mods. Sometimes I play with private mods and I don't know that they're private. And I got to get all that figured out. But join the Discord, link in the description if you guys ever want to play with me. I'm serious. Like, you're going to see people on here. And I just said, hey, come play with me. Anyway, here's the 40-foot trailer. She's a beast. One thing I got to figure out is better spots for trailer parking. I was thinking kind of on this side. One, they're off the road so people don't come looking late at night. And they're kind of close by my house. Again, so security purposes, nobody's stealing trailers. And I don't have to lock them up always. Because I'll have cameras out here. And yeah, I'm thinking I'm going to put a bit more concrete. I'll probably just put more gravel down right here. Then that'll be all trailer spot. So I'm going to work on that. Go grab the other two trailers. Well, what do you think of the place? It's pretty sick. I love just the house is beautiful. And then you have the shop here. I like kind of how the house is a little more tucked away, a little more hidden behind the shop. So it's not just so much on the road. Sometimes I drive by like country houses like that, that are really nice, but they're like right on the road. And it just feels like, I don't know. It feels like you can see through their windows. Seems like the traffic car noise is going to be loud. I don't know. Personally, I like the houses tucked back rather than up on the road if you can help it. So here's the Casey's, like I said, less than a quarter mile away. So I can literally walk down there, fill up a 5-gallon jug of gas if I need to early in the morning. Oh, that's so nice. So let's pick up the other trailers and then I'm going to try bring them all down and then we're going to get a few lawns mowed here. All right, I'm loaded up, ready to go. We're going to go get two lawns done this afternoon just so I feel like I'm productive. We can make some money. Just file all the diesel we're spending running back and forth. So we can get into town. Got the first cuts of the year coming up. Been having really good weather. It's early April, so it is early probably for the first cut. 1 or 2 weeks early, but we've had 70s. I think one day was 80. Plenty of rain just to let the grass come back to life. So it's been a lot of fun here. All right, and there is one of my favorite restaurants. Back there in that strip mall. Applebee's isn't too bad either. This is kind of the main strip. There's the football stadium. We got a huge football stadium, which is pretty cool to see. Here we go. Here's the first blade start of the year. Okay, I will lie. I did start the blades earlier, but let's go ahead, lower down the deck. And there we go. We're ready. So this first one is a pretty small. I mean, it's a medium-sized commercial account that we have. They have two side yards. They actually don't have that much grass space for how big like the shop is, or the warehouse, I guess you want to say. We do got to get around this old water tower here. There we go. Can't get underneath too much. We usually let that grow out. We mow it about every 4 weeks up underneath there. It's like they got some pretty bad weeds growing already. Dang. I told them we could have them on our weed program in our, where we do fertilizer, we spray for weeds, a lot of that stuff, but it does get pretty expensive and I don't think they care too much. There we go. She's looking good. Here comes the train. And then we have airless tires on this too. So that's been really nice. Haven't, of course, had a flat and they've held up pretty good over the years. I haven't had any problems, so I always go with them. And seems like we always, especially on the commercial accounts, there's always junk in the yard just because nobody's out there to clean it up but us. So the airless tires, they come in handy because we're always running over pop cans, nails, all that stuff. But this place is called Black Sheep. I actually haven't even mowed this account in a while. I think they're a clothing brand I'm not too sure. Maybe they're food or something, but pretty big company. Let's get turned around. I got two more passes. Then we got to do a little other space over on the other side of the parking lot. And we should be good to go. Shut down the blade, lift the deck. All right, now we're doing the backside here. The lot is pretty small. I'll show you guys once we turn back around. It actually cuts off like halfway. It cuts off where like the building is. But yeah, for the size of this place, we got them We get them at a pretty good price. I'm happy with it. It's pretty, doesn't take too long, but we get paid pretty good for these commercial lots. There we go. Here's about the property line. It's always kind of tough on this one. What's nice is that big open field, they don't own that. That's a separate, like, vacant lot right now. So that's kind of nice. We don't have to do that, but I'm going to get this back end knocked around. It's about like 5-10 passes, and then past the brush, it's just that other side that you saw. So let's get her knocked out. And there we go. Looks good. We got this side done. I'm going to run on the road real quick, try and see how fast this mower goes. There we go. But let's get her loaded up. That's going to wrap up today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. We got the shop done. We got everything kind of moved in. Well, we didn't get everything, but we'll have more moved in here shortly. And thank you guys so much for watching. Smash the like button, and I'll see you in the next one.